next team up is Teenage Mutant Ninja Poets with Ma, Derek Glynn, Josh Bjornberg, Victoria Dest, and Cody Shanks.
Is that good?
Everyone has unfortunately experienced some too many awkward moments. Most occur in adolescence on accident, but end in amusement and befuddlements. You don't mean for them to happen, but eventually, they always do. You probably wouldn't have done what you did if only you knew. Like that time when someone was waving at you and you enthusiastically were back in excitement. Hey, hey, how are you? But then you realized that person wasn't waving at you. Oh, not. Oh. So next comes disappointment with immediate resentment, and embarrassment is just an understatement. Sometimes you just can't control when you're victim to an awkward situation. But if you find yourself in these encounters on multiple occasions, your timing may need some reevaluation. Like that time when you start telling a story to your friends. Hey guys, last night I was, but they're not listening like they should be. So naturally, you'll play it off jokingly. Oh, cool guys, it's no big deal. Trending. Though you feel sympathetic for their misfortune, you can't help but laugh at the ending. Like that time when you started waiting and you're trying to get their attention, but you really just can't. Hey, hey, oh, Josh, Josh. It only ends in misapprehension, which wasn't your intention to make sure to mention, but now you're just trapped in an awkward tension. So they try to force a laugh. Or change the topic as if it's really no big deal. But with your blushed cheeks and averted eye contact, embarrassment is kind of hard to conceal. But my advice to you in these awkward moments are simple and worthwhile. To alleviate the awkwardness, just laugh at yourself and smile. Embrace your awkward moments, because in some scenarios, they're just expected. Then you won't seem as effective when they're easily reflected if you stay cool, calm, and collected. Awkward moments are inevitable. There are just some things you have to accept. But if you really can't recover from total embarrassment, simply walking away is probably best.
Judges' scores are 9, 9, 9.5, 8.5, 9, and 9.5.
Well, that was awkward. It's upsetting how I can fit my whole life story on a one-page book and how my last relationship lasted less than it takes Easy Mac to cook. It's like I'm walking on two broken legs. I just fall so easily. I see you once and now I'm crushing and I don't know the reason. See, it's impossible for me to act like they cease to exist. One of the many downfalls of being an opportunist. It's hard to just sit there and not get pissed when a girl walks away with the chance you just missed. But I learned from my mistakes, so it won't happen again, because next time that's sure as hell not how it's going to end. But personally, something just occurred to me, an impurity, as the girls might see this as immaturity. They don't give me a chance because they think there's no cure for me, but then if they did, I would keep them safer than security. They think that I won't love them, I put my friends above them, or shove them into a relationship hotter than an oven. So I sit here writing jingles, and my mouth mingles with Pringles, my body starts to tingle, and my skin begins to wrinkle, and oh, by the way, did I mention that I'm single?
Fresh.
words.
We don't think twice about the things we say. Negatively, positively, our words, they sway. We don't think twice about what they mean. Our words picture a powerful scene. Words come in many different sizes, prefixes and suffixes, origins and meanings. They're all important. Words depict our feelings. It's what makes us human beings. The way we bend our words to hide what we mean, the way we mend our words because they can be so mean. They can signify our love and make us feel like we're in the clouds above. But all this doesn't matter because the way we use our words is one big disaster. We hold our heads up high, not giving a damn about others who pass you by. Until they pass you by, and the words begin to flow through your brain. You open your mouth and the words begin to rain. Wow, that guy is so fat. Yo, she looks like a rat. OMG, look at that hair. Yo, dude, that guy's hairier than a bear. These phrases may seem funny to you, but think about what some people have to go through. Constantly being ridiculed because of the way they look, talk, or dress, it leaves people in a constant state of distress. Day by day, hour by hour, words continue to flow, and they still continue to smack you in the face like when the cold wind blows. Imagine if all these crude words weren't used in our society. There would be so much less anxiety, we'd live in a constant state of propriety. We go along with our lives, wasting our opportunities to say the right thing. We forget that Martin Luther King fought for the very same thing. There is no need for our words to cause decay. It's essential to watch what we say. Take the time to think what your words might portray. So keep it clean, don't be mean, and have a BEA beautiful day.
Judges scores!
Oh, yeah, Derek!
Are 9, 8.5, 8.5, 9, 9, and 9.
Everyone has something that makes their own beat.
I swim.
I dive.
I pitch.
I eat.
Yeah, fine.
But I play soccer in the fall. Don't forget about me.
Can you grab me my goggles?
And a large number 3.
I swim. I swim 2 laps.
I do 2 dives.
I take 2 balls.
I eat 2 pies.
I throw 2 pitches.
In my speedo, I flex.
I love my dinner.
But I wear spandex.
We had like 50 people up in those seats.
We had like 3 people at our last meet.
I scored 3 goals.
Damn, you're a beast.
I won my races, but I just finished my feast.
Everyone has something that makes their own beat.
I dive my best every day of the week, and when that meet comes, I don't get beat. I do flips, twists, enter the body clean. Maybe it's cause my body's so lean.
Everyone has something that makes their own beat. They say I'm the best lefty they've seen, and my curveball will spook you like it's Halloween. Strike 1, strike 2, strike 3, you will not get a hit off me. Pretty soon you'll see me through your color TV. Everyone has something that makes their own beat.
I give 100% no matter what, because Coach said it's all being mentally tough, because having skill with no determination just isn't enough. So I'll dangle a few defenders, just run by for a breakaway. They were talking smack before, but now they don't have anything to say.
Everyone has something that makes their own beat.
J-O-S-H, you can call me J-P. And when I'm in the pool, I do the Preston free. I wear Speedos in practice, I wear Speedos when I wear Speedos at home, I wear Speedos in gym.
Everyone has something that makes their own beat.
Eating is what I do. Pizza, burgers, fries, just to name a few. The food I eat complements my pleasantly plump shape. Mickey D's is my paradise escape. I eat with passion and grace. It's unique the way I stuff my face. When it comes to eating food, I'm the best. You guys remember that pie eating contest? I can't help it. It's what I do. Yo, Lambo, you ready for round 2?
Everyone has something that makes their own beat.
We're all friends no matter what we do.
No matter what clicking, when no matter what we do.
We all look different. We all look different, but really, we're all the same.
We're just some kids playing this high school game.
Kick.
Swim.
Pitch.
Dive.
And eat.
Everyone has something that makes their own beat.
Nine point five, 9.5, 10.
Yeah!
9.5 and 10.